Good morning. My name is Chuck Von Henschel, and I'm the milk sales manager for Creamland Dairies here in Albuquerque, New Mexico, home of the largest ballooning event in the world. Creamland Dairies has been a part of this fiesta since 1989. The fiesta actually started with 13 balloons back in 1973, and it's grown to well over 800 balloons today. Creamland decided to become a part of it in 1989 for the marketing aspect of it. Since our inception in 1989, we've actually became a major sponsor of the Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta. We are the official milk and ice cream of the Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta. This is the third generation Airabelle. This particular balloon only has about 11 flight hours on her. This is, as I said, third generation. The first Airabelle took off from this field in 1989. She adored the crowd. She took special shapes, the people's choice special shapes of that particular year. Since then, we've had the opportunity to introduce a second Airabelle in 1996 during the 25th anniversary. We flew the second generation Airabelle. She took off behind Airabelle number one. We were very lucky to have two cow balloons in the air at the same time. In that year, we also took People's Choice as the best special shape of the International Balloon Fiesta. Since then, it's becoming a marketing phenomenon. We've been requested to fly all over the United States for Dean Foods. Dean Foods now owns the balloon. It was owned by several different companies over the years, but since then we've decided it is such a great marketing tool for us and Dean Foods that we decided we should own the program and promote the program to help promote dairies across the country. I used to be the crew chief for this wonderful program. I have since relinquished those duties to a very capable individual named Jeff Jorg, who I'll introduce to you here in just a moment. I would love to have continued to be crew chief of this, but through the graces of God and my company, I've been promoted, and now I've got a company to run and not a balloon to run. So with that, I'd like to bring in and introduce Jeff Jorg, the current crew chief. Jeff?
Thanks, Chuck. How you doing? My name's Jeff Jorg. I am the account manager and marketing manager at Creamland Dairies here in Albuquerque, New Mexico. I was lucky enough, I'm in my fifth year at Creamland Dairies, and I am lucky enough to inherit a program that was well established and was probably one of the best programs, or is the best program here at the Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta. We have, in the last 7 years, we've taken the People's Choice Award 5 times out of 7 years, and we're going for our sixth this year. This year, basically since I've taken over the program from Chuck, we've added another balloon. We now have a round balloon that we have on hand, which we fly with the cow balloon, and we also, the biggest reason that we brought the round balloon in is with the Albuquerque weather, you never know what you're gonna get. So what we've done is we wanted to have a round balloon on hand that we could always have the option of flying. There are certain days, because of the size of the cow balloon and the appendages, we really need perfect conditions to fly that particular balloon, the cow balloon. Now we have the option on days where it's a little bit more breezy, the weather is a little more inclement, we're able to fly that round balloon and still get our name out there amongst all of the people who are attending the Albuquerque Balloon Fiesta. I have here Leroy Salazar, who I will introduce to you in just 1 second. Leroy is the crew chief of the round balloon, and I'll have him say a few words on the round balloon.
At 10 o'clock this morning, just after we brought back the Indian National System. So it's going to be a very special day with our salute to veterans as they head to the White House International Association, Ascension, this morning. A little closer, we'll come back to what we're going to tonight for the balloon flow, where we'll put about 300 balloons on the field here, and it's twilight setting in, light them up like giant fireflies in the twilight. And then that will be followed by the afterglow.
America's Challenge gas balloon race. And happy to report to you that all of the balloons are still flying at this hour. The several of the teams are making excellent progress. The lead team as of 4:30 this morning was the German team of Strassmann and Herkenhoff.
Okay.
They were currently about 59 miles northwest of Clovis.
Very exciting. Okay, sometime later.
For our Roadrunner Coyote Challenge, or our Fiesta Challenge, which is officially called.
Hey, John, is that enough room for everything out through here with
our team? Yeah.
No problem.
I've already called.
Are those ones comfortable? Yeah.
There you go.
Wait a minute.
Almost Chamber of Commerce ready for our second mass ascension at the Albuquerque International.
Yep, okay. Let's spin. Start spinning, okay. And then walk about 5 feet to the left. There we go, down. Thank you.
Albuquerque Beautiful has placed green recycling bins on the stage over on Concession Row. For those of you to put your
raised $300,000.
John's going to want to do a pre-birth.
The Duke City Chorus. They will be presenting the national anthem in just a few moments as soon as they're ready.
Well,
the colors should have another couple of minutes. Again, a reminder for those of you out on the field, please pay
extra attention, if you will.
Just as they do issue those instructions, you have to comply with those instructions.
Is right in the middle of sponsor row here.
Oh, I see.
That fish is ready to go from Rima.
Here goes your dragon, Justin.
Thank you.
ride? No?
MPS, or money processing systems,
as an airborne airborne. It is teal with kind of a black and pink, again, I refer to it as sort of a peacock feather fan effect on the bottom of the sides of the balloon. It does pour in. Another balloon is sponsored by the Santa Ana Institute. Sort of across. Session row now. Funny Bear, Juan Antonio de Santo Fogata. Sorry if I'm butchering your name. Not very good. What is it? I'm not very good at kind of learning my Portuguese yet. Hey, that was one heck of a drink yesterday. Thank you for that.
Staff and the pilots and officials each year. Out of the middle of the field, another friend of mine is from Longview, Texas. He is Guy Gauthier. Guy is getting airborne now in his balloon called Kilroy. Those of you who are members of the Greatest Generation lived through World War II, in particular, remember the little cartoon character that American soldiers scribbled on brick walls and concrete. And the logo, of course, Kilroy was here, and Kilroy appearing over the top of that wall. Or actually, in this case, it's simply an opening in the side of the balloon. It's been another absolutely picture-perfect morning for ballooning, as you can tell, as we continue with launching these 750 balloons that make up this morning's mass ascension. Out in the eastern edge of the field there, again, on the concession row, coming out of the backside of the field, the Plano, Texas balloon. Diane Carlson, her husband Ron Carlson, flying the balloon as Google ambassadors for the city of Plano, Texas. And like our friends in St. John's and Richelieu and Gatineau, Canada, Plano also hosts a very fine balloon event of its own, held the third weekend of every September in Plano, Texas, and that's located just north of Dallas. They're somewhere on the north side of the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex.
If you're not familiar with where Plano, Texas is. Good to see them in the air this morning. And we continue with the launch again now from the second wave of the Fiestas. We now see the yellow Zia, well, Michael McConnell was off very early this morning, and now our red Zia also getting airborne, the red balloon with the yellow Zia on the side. And if I'm not mistaken, that would be Thomas Hora flying the Red Zia in balloon number 603. Another Louisiana pilot here with us, Art. And to my left is David Yob, in his balloon 602. Again, one of those black balloons. It looks like someone just spilled a bucket of rainbow-colored paint all over it. There is the not one-eyed but two-eyed purple people eater. This is John Cabot in his little special shape. Not little, but interesting special shape. The purple people eater with those green, whatever they are, thingies hanging off the side of it. Kind of an interesting creature to see. Now there's Jim Hershen again in the Alltel balloon. Blue, white, and black flying for Alltel. Jim out of the Branson, Missouri area. Mentioned our experiences with Jim earlier, getting the chance to fly down in Marvel Cave. Doing a little underground ballooning a few years ago. Over along Concession Row, ladies and gentlemen, from Creamland Dairies, there is Arabella the cow. This is the third version of the cow. We talked about her earlier. Always voted one of the top three special shapes here at Fiesta by you, the visitors to Fiesta. Blake's Lotteberger balloon is also airborne over the top of us now. And their balloon, another yet of those black balloons. It looks like it has rainbow paint spilled on the top of it. Don Chalmers Ford, the official chase vehicle sponsor. Ford, of course, the official truck of the Fiesta. And Don Chalmers Ford balloon, that is Jerry Kingsley. They're just to our left now, flying right out over their corporate hospitality tent this morning. And a couple of soft drink balloons, the Dr. Pepper balloon airborne, burgundy and white. And that is Robert Ambo. Robert here from Gonzales, Louisiana, flying for Dr. Pepper. And just to our left and his left is the Coca-Cola balloon, and that's Gary Cass. Out of used to be out of the great state of Nebraska, now calls Yuma, Arizona home. Gary's away in the Coca-Cola balloon. There's a good look at the airborne laser balloon.
But now I work at an elementary school, so it never stops. This is my 11th year for Creamland.
What's your name?
Yvonne Esposito.
Yeah.
normally that would be Richard Abruzzo flying in that balloon, but Richard is away, obviously, as you just heard, flying in the America's Challenge gas balloon race, and so an alternate pilot taking care of the duties as a hot air balloon today. It is being mentioned, though, that both Richard Abruzzo and Carl Reimer Davis, recently winners of the world's most prestigious balloon race, the Crew Aboard Invented, the traditional long-distance gas balloon race, and
Davis landed 51 miles northwest of Dumas and traveled 225 miles. But what's interesting is that the last that I heard yesterday, the German team of Strassmann and Herkenhoff were well out into the lead, and now they've actually fallen, well, they've landed, and they're a good 140 miles up behind.
Pin with you then.
Only because you have a good action knowledge.
The action works every time. Look, I'm crewed by these guys.
Oh, cool. That's cool.
So I got a good pin as well.
All right. Well, I'm going to fix
I came,
you right
I
up.
Came over yesterday, but the guy said, I don't have any pins.
Oh, that's okay.
He said,
you come, come to see the right guy.
I know. Now, what do I have to do to get a T-shirt, though? I got a T-shirt back in 96, I got a T-shirt, I think. Yeah. Right.
You will.
Tell you what. Thursday.
That's my busy day, okay. Now they got the horses, Ashley.
Davey's going to put you right in there. Okay. So, his name is Dave also. Dave Mines.
I need your car.
Actually,
I
have a horse.
Andrew Cole, Zubacek, all out there. All from Adjective and Wine Wall.
Is it beautiful? I never do that again. I take 4,000.
You're this side?
Skinner, S-V-I-N-N-E-R, at MILWPC.com.
Sorry, I gave you a card number.
Yeah, I got your card yesterday.
I'm going to do these up, though, okay? Let me do these.
I'm hoping the girls will come with you and make some stuff.
If I do it a certain way, I'll let all of them.
These are the guys that, he's the like the head guy at Sundance in Canada.
Concussion?
Does a lot of events in Canada. deal is.
Hi there, balloonist. And you don't have to be a balloonist to join the BFA. You don't have to be a pilot. You don't even have to crew for a balloon. All you really have to do is have a love for the sport of ballooning in one fashion or another. The membership of the organization gets you a monthly newsletter, a bi-monthly four-color magazine, as well as some other benefits that can be you can learn all about in the BFA tent, the Balloon Federation of America, their tent right next door to the manufacturer tents, which are located at the south end of the field, just next door to the big grill of Harley Davidson Motorcycle. They are, you came for another register for pool prizes each day, and also do a little shopping. The holidays aren't that far off, and time to go down and do some shopping and perhaps find some unique arts and crafts, some handmade items that your friends or maybe that you're buying for will certainly appreciate. This is a juried arts and crafts show, so it's a pretty high quality material, and they'd be glad to see you down there. All of the vendors, of course, along Bender Road, as far as we know, are still open this morning for business, whether they be selling food or merchandise. A good time to, if you haven't already, to pick up whatever official Fiesta souvenir you're interested in, be it pins, patch. And of course, we have our own sportswear tent as well, with the official sportswear or outerwear for Fiesta. Quite a selection of
you can grab whichever pole they like. I think
so we have had a wonderful day while you visit here at Fiesta. We're disappointed as you are that the balloons could not fly this morning. Our thanks again to Wells Fargo, who had sponsored today, as well as Fargo Credit Card Day. Also to Contractors Bonding, who was the sponsor of what was to be the New Mexico Challenge race. And I'm assuming that we'll get that rescheduled for another day this week. But it's just one of those things about ballooning is we are weather dependent this morning. After a change of course style weekend, Mother Nature just doesn't seem to want to play the games with us today. So enjoy your morning, especially enjoy your time shopping along Bender Row. And we'll see you back, I guess, tomorrow morning, unless Tommy, you have something else of note to pass along to the folks before we say goodbye.
No, but I guess the one thing I would say.
So there's lots to do, so please come back and see us in the morning, but spend the day here in one of the most beautiful places in the world.
This state is always the land of enchantment, so there's no reason to sit in a hotel room all day for every state, looking to see us on TV. We have a lot of enchanted things all around you to take part of.
So for that,
sure.
So we hope that you get to see us. We're really glad that you're part of the Balloon Fiesta and all of us in Albuquerque. Love having you here, and are anxious for you to see what a wonderful place it is in which we live.
With that, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of my cohort and partner in crime, Todd Bolivar, I'm Glenn Moore. We'll see you bright and early tomorrow morning, and hopefully we can kick off our daily balloon competitions. Until then, as Tom said, please go out and see if some of this beautiful land and children. We'll be back with you bright and early just before the sun comes over us and comes up over the Sandia tomorrow. Have a great day.
No, I'm good. No. Oh, I'm gonna go tight. Now that's my altitude line.
Yay.
Good. Good job.
Right here.
I'll watch him coming.
Watch yourself, those lines are going to go swinging up.
Yeah.
Hello, it's Chuck. Yes.
How are you? Good morning. How are you? Good. Good. So much easier. Grab here.
Call me baby.
Is it backup time?
Yeah. Hold on. Hang on. Just sit tight for a second. Just lean your head. Just lean your head on it. Get some of this air out.
Can we go all the way back to you?
I know. What did he say? On three. Start backing up. Yeah. One, two, three. Back. Stop.
Bring it in.
Bring it in. Matt, are you the end?
Got about 65.
No, bring that in.
Okay, let's step in. Okay, let's everybody on the back to bring in on it.
Oh wait, hold on.
Okay,
back up, ready? One, two, three.
Back up.
Okay, shove.
Did you call?
Don't push me. Don't push me.
And then they just
We got it.
One, two, three, go.
He's right there. He's talking to Dad.
I'm
going
to
throw you on top.
You?
On top.
Step on
top.
See, to earn your pin and shirt step that I'm going to give you?
Yes. Yep.
You have to dance.
Jump up and down.
Watch out, don't go.
Oh, sorry.
I got you.
That's not funny.
Gabe does that on purpose.
You know what I mean? Under your arm?
Okay, dip that stuff out.
Okay, I'm going to pull you stuff.
Matt, grab the rope, pull it back a little bit.
So they always grab the new ones and make them put it down.
Nice for three in the fourth part. Three. You get a big roll bar. It's 223 and a half. So in light and variable winds, you can't feel it. You can't. There's, you're stuck. And you're like, you got people here. He's like, excuse me. Just put that Velcro back on there. We just actually just go from four hands to get one. Two, three. There's actually no zipper. The zipper broke.
We might as well just put this back in our trailer. It's Thursday.
Well, I was going to do that.
No problem. I didn't know if you had something open.
Yeah, I should have done. Did we do mine too? You did? Oh, I gotta put my.
Hey, guys!
Guys! My fan!
I understand. Shopping.
Yes.
Shopping.
When you get everything after that, then you've got everything closed off. Everyone together, everybody else. You're going to want to give them that. Just see if you're done. And what I'll do is, if
I can. No problem, go ahead. I just want the real thing.
Yeah, I gave him that.
I knew Jason loved the answer.
I got to go up there and start. He said. Okay. And for some reason, I don't think we're going to take off the cocaine here. Yeah. But it's just right over the
Oh yeah, I know.